Welcome, welcome. Welcome back for those of you who were with us for season one of Know the Code. Season two is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be an evolving format. Trying to present something a little bit different. This episode's topic, Igloo University. If you're here, you've probably seen a post. I've been going as ham as I could for this past month. A little 28-day content campaign, trying to see what type of traction I can gain organically with an idea. That came to fruition, you know what I'm saying, more recently, but the philosophy of it has been coming together over a long span of time. After learning the lesson, it took me a while to find the words to properly get it out, you know what I'm saying, say what it is really. And it's like this. As a creative, like you scroll through whatever platform, on your phone, any piece of content, someone like you made that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to say that to make you pump up your chest, because a lot of the shit that's out there is kind of not it. So, you know what I'm saying? That's the point I'm really trying to get to. Like, as creatives, we control everything that people see. We control what they consume visually, the sounds they hear. Even when we do it for a company for, you know what I'm saying, and it's for marketing purposes, we still and as a creative, if you made it a point to improve what you need to improve on your end so that you're a better version of yourself every time you're creating. I'm saying not every time, but you know what I mean? You're continually evolving, growing, and allowing yourself to not always fill more roles, but provide more value, because that's a valuable asset to have when, especially when you have multiple skills on deck. It's like, you know what I'm saying, they call those utility players in baseball. And or like a guy in basketball on defense that can guard multiple positions. Like those type of players are what you call the glue on your team. You know what I'm saying? The ones who make sure shit don't fall through the cracks on days when this person has an injury or that person's not available. I can't do that as well. But we're gonna hold it down for today and get through to tomorrow. And a lot of times when you're starting out, something new, like all hands on deck, and the hands on deck gonna have to wear a couple hats. Why not wear them well? You know, in some instances, you're wearing the shit out of the hats. You're already wearing. What? It's better. It's more you can offer. It's more in you. Quite frankly. You gotta make it a habit of letting all this in you out. So there's room for more to manifest. Like, as a creative, you tap into the source, the vortex, the universe. And as a creator, with that access, you come with responsibility. It can't be just a situation where can be. Let me not say that, because quite frankly, you can do what you've been doing, and if that shit's fit to your family, fuck what I'm talking about. But if perchance think there's more in you when you're trying to figure out how to get that shit up out of you, this is that. This is how you go out. This is when you go out into the wilderness, chop some trees, hunt some deer. Bring it all back to the farm. And that's if you're a creative and start reinstalling. Like sometimes you can't even call yourself a creative because you're starting out. But you know you got creativity in you. You know you got a business. And you know content marketing. It's the move, it's the wave. And you might want to figure out how and start wearing a couple more hats, because on that start out, you can get caution. And not having it to start out can be dejecting. But if you can put time, energy, and effort and turn it into something that can get you what you need to start out, that's something you should seek out. That's something that BU University is looking to provide. In one of the videos, I equated it to the off season. Like with athletes, win, lose, or draw. When that off season come around, they plan it for the next season. And your off season, think about the off season could be, like for athletes, it's a couple months, but for you, it could be a couple hours in between projects, 30 minutes here and there, where you could brush up on something and I know kung fu. It's about raising the ball, your ball. Continually. Whatever that looks like for you. And doing it in a way that gets it done. Not what I'm trying to say here. Your process is valid. Whatever you had to go through to get it done is what you had to go through to get it done. It's going to take some self-awareness to recognize what it took in some cases to duplicate it, because some people hit it big one time, but the ones who keep it going are usually the ones that had to make it do what it do over and over again to the compound. Gotta do the math. All right. Moving forward. One thing I want to talk about. Some NFTs. I'm just trying to get my hours in. I'm about 4 or 5 hours of research, and I need some more, I know. But I just think it's something you need to look into too, because it's like has the potential to create a whole copycat economy, like for content consumption of NFTs. Like, it's not guaranteed, but it might be need to be a YouTube for NFTs one day. An Instagram, you know what I mean? Just like someplace that can be showcased, and an Amazon of NFTs or whatever, you know what I mean? And there's other tertiary jobs, you know what I'm saying, pop up around it. And it's about having foresight. Like, one of my earlier posts, I said, like, the social media is like the Wild Wild West. And if you have any knowledge of how that developed, like, it started out with pioneers standing out, exploring, figuring what shit, you know what I'm saying, trailblazing, coming back with news. Like, hey, this is that. That is this. Here's the map to it. Other niggas followed. Figured out that shit is for real. Started realizing that everybody making a move was like, hey, let's build this railroad. Okay, but yeah, what were we on? Railroads, yeah. They built the railroads. And on certain points of that railroad, some people had the foresight to build. Build up stores and towns and lodgings. Because they knew that railroad was going to bring more people. And niggas was chopping on that railroad because they was all heading after them gold mines. Call them the 49ers. And this is another one of those opportunities. Civilization is being rebuilt digitally. Everything we do is going to have a digital interface. In the future. And quite frankly, right now, most things do have some sort of digital. Like, it's here. It's not as far away as people may want to make it seem. But back to why it's important to artists. I think like I said, there might be a new tool, it might be a new streaming platforms too. Or it might completely disrupt streaming. Or add a different facet to it, because you could put like an original song on an NFT, like when Wu-Tang sold old buddy that album for $2 million. Like, that's like an NFT. Like, Bobby Shmurda could probably sell his first feature. Or sell, you know what I'm saying, his first album as an NFT. Might be able to bust whatever, what? Logan Paul made like $3 million on his when he dropped joints, that joint? I don't know. He sell some feature, some 16-bar feature NFTs. Like, I don't even know if it's possible, but you know what I'm saying? It's like I seen this one meme, little dude. He was running around school, selling all the white kids in the school passes to say the N-word. That's like an NFT. Like, it's being creative, putting value on ideas. Like, artists can put out songs, like producers can sell beats, do NFTs maybe, yeah, I think so, yeah. Like, and if video directors can license their videos as NFTs, I think that will shake shit up. You could maybe even get funding for something with an NFT. Like, I got a dope movie idea. You get the funding, drop the bag. Rental properties, rental spaces, like access to a location, purchasing this, you know? It's gonna get crazy. I don't know. I still got to learn more about it. I'm just talking out the side of my neck right now. That's the ranting part of the segment. To what I was saying about these creators. You got a responsibility. Like, you niggas can't keep giving these rappers these whack ass treatments where they all stand in front of their fucking cars or in front of their front yard or in a parking lot somewhere. 300 motherfuckers all in one location. Like, that shit, it's not safe. Be a little creative. Like, put them on a plane somewhere, go to some, take your artist someplace, write something that takes them someplace they ain't never been. I promise you, niggas seen the video at the barbershop. We seen that. You can do it, you might be able to do it in a way that's dope, but you can take it further. About challenge, whatever the last word, you know what I'm saying, whatever you, wherever you at, see if you got more. If you don't got more, that's okay too. And I don't want to make it seem like but if you're trying to level up, you can. It's possible. That first step, and sometimes you gotta learn along the way, cause you ain't gonna have all, you won't have all the answers starting out, but as you start out, some of the answers to the questions that you have, they pop up, you know what I'm saying, you start figuring shit out, you know what I'm saying, there's some answers you can only get on the third or fourth step, or third or fourth failure, the third or fourth restart, third or fourth reboot, third or fourth successful campaign, third or fourth expansion. Like certain lessons only happen on certain levels, but you gotta get to them joints, and you gotta do the things you gotta do to get to them. What you're doing is working. Keep on doing that. That's being glued too. But if you're looking ahead, and you're seeing what you're doing, more will be required. Sometimes more will be required than you already got it in the bag. So it's like, okay, you plan for it, you streamline, you step right into it. But sometimes you see more is required and it's coming. It's like, okay, I don't got that. What would having that look like? Okay, all right. Okay, this is how I have to have it for what we do. Okay, it lines up after a while, but. Occasionally, it's like, you know what I'm saying, you can wing it, like, all right, along the way. They say that's New York nigga swag, like, what you need? All right, let me get that for you. Nigga dip off, like, all right, the homie need, come back with exactly what you need, but, you know what I'm saying? Whether or not they already did that, they figured out how to do it and got it to you. And you don't gotta label it that, it's just that go-getter mentality. Like you need something, I'm a person that takes care of those things. I'll be right back. Or you need a visual, or you need a motherfucking logo, you need a You need a t-shirt, you need a pitch deck, you need a, like, whatever it may be. It's about having that foresight. Having the foresight and the follow through to do what foresight tells you. Because a lot of niggas, they see plays. They won't run them. Seeing them ain't enough. Gotta run them joints. They don't always run the way you plan, but the fact that you had a plan, an outline, the fact that you made a decision to do this, made it so, even though there was aberrations and deviations, she still got done. So, long story short, we're gonna try to build. Get you some wanna be a resource. You know what I'm saying? Get you some help where you need it. Or an opportunity to offer help where others need it. Because it could be that too. Still figuring it out. It's changing every day. It's growing every day. It's getting stronger every day. See what it do. Thanks for joining. Catch you tomorrow, IG Live. Gonna discuss the brand, the B Glue brand. Shit, that shit tongue tied like a motherfucker. Okay. Bring it back. Tomorrow on IG Live, gonna talk about the B Glue University Brand Lounge. Talk about some of the apps I use. Talk about the process of curating some of the videos that I use to help tell my brand story. Open, you know what I'm saying, on the open up. It's like, in my mind, I envision it like throwing a fire in the wilderness. And trying to let everybody know they can come get some warmth. Warmth. And now that you hear about a fire, I can tell you how I got this shit lit. And that's what we're gonna get into. Be honest.